sweet and savory creations. Tonight or today, I'm going to do for you broccoli and cheddar cheese soup. Yes, you know how long I've been wanting to make this. So, you know, on typical nights like this one here where I'm in Ohio, it's kind of chilly. And, you know, it's that season for that comfort foods. And soup is one of them. And this is not a really hard recipe to do. It's quick, it's easy, and you can pair it up with some bread, some French loaf bread, crackers. I might do a little cornbread later, I'm not sure. But I'm going to get into these ingredients for this recipe. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. I appreciate everyone that has done so far. So we're going to get into these ingredients. Of course, we have 3 crowns of broccoli, which I'm going to cut off the stems. We have our pepper. I have some garlic powder. I have some parsley. And some salt, some seasoning salt. I have some evaporated milk. I have some whole milk that I'm gonna do. Some butter. And also have my cheddar cheese. And my cheddar cheese, see that. And also my flour over here, which I'm gonna make my roux out of. That's the foundation for your. Now you can add, if you want to, you can add give me a bowl here. You can add chicken stock in this for more flavor. I might have chicken stock, but you can add that in. So we're just going to start cutting the broccoli off the stems. I'm gonna make sure you guys can see. Okay, so we're just gonna start chopping it off the stems. You can leave the stems on there if you like. I am, because that's the best part to me, the stems. I'm not gonna leave all of it on, so I cut that off. So we're just gonna place this over here in this bowl off to the side until we get it all cut up. Then we're going to start making our roux. And anybody that makes macaroni and cheese or anything gravy, it's the same process, just making it for like a soup. So broccoli cheddar cheese soup is one of my favorite soups. I really like broccoli. Just about everywhere, any restaurant I go to, if they have the broccoli and cheddar, I get it. And it's good, you know. I used to go to Subway all the time and get theirs. But I think they changed their recipe some, because it tastes a little different. I'm not sure what it is. It's like, to me, a bad aftertaste that I'm tasting. So, I'm going to discard of this. It's a little more broccoli over there. And now I'm done with this. So I'm going to put this over here. Put my bag over here. So now we have our broccoli all cut up. We are going to start on this roux. I'm going to put the broccoli over here. I'm going to start on this roux. I'm going to put some margarine, maybe about that much in there, just to get it started. And we're going to put, I think I'm going to use 2 tablespoons of flour. So I'm just putting that much of the margarine in there. If you want to use real butter, you can. Okay, yeah, I got the tablespoon already. So we're just going to let this start to melt. And I'm going to bring you guys up some, a little bit closer so you guys can see. And once we make the roux, we're going to get the milk and the carnation. I'm going to mix carnation and milk in with this. So I'm just going to use a heaping tablespoon, two, of flour, like that. I'm just going to let the butter, so I'm going to take this out the way because I don't need this one anymore. If I needed some more, you know what? I'm going to set it right there. You never know. Okay, so I'm going to let this melt. This is how it look right now because the butter hasn't melted or the margarine. But once it melt, I'm going to stir the flour around. You just want it, you don't want it to brown like you're making flour, I mean gravy. You just want it to, you know, become a glue. And this is your glue for your soup. So we're just going to let this sit here, and I'm going to come back when it's a glue. Okay, so I'm back, and as you see, I have made my glue. This is my foundation for my soup. So I'm just going to add in milk. And we're just going to keep working this in. So I added a cup of milk. I'm going to add more. And I'm adding in carnation as well. And then we're going to season this with, I'm gonna let this come up, but while it's coming up, because it's gonna get thick, I'm gonna start just whisking it in from the bottom. And it's gonna get thick, and that's gonna be our soup foundation. The cheese not in there yet, I'm gonna put the cheese in last. So we're just gonna start seasoning this. Gonna use some parsley. I'm going to add some garlic powder in, some garlic powder. Oh, I wish I had some well, you know what? I could use no. I was thinking about using some cream of chicken in it, but no, not gonna do that. Not gonna do that. And I'm out of chicken bouillon. And I was at the store, y'all, yesterday for 2 hours almost, and I still didn't get no chicken broth. And I look right at it and I said, oh yeah, I'm gonna get some. I'm terrible. Okay, and then I'm going to add in some black pepper. So I'm gonna add in some black pepper to this soup base. And I'm going to add in another cup of milk because I want it to be liquidy. I want to make sure it's plenty of liquid. So I'm going to add in another cup of milk. Another cup and a half. Do a cup and a half. Okay, so that's 2 cups and a half of milk that I use, a whole thing of carnation milk. And so we're just gonna give this a whisk. Stove cleaned off here. Give this a whisk. It's looking good. Oh, I know what I can use. See, with cooking, you always could improvise. And I have some, you know, the my peanut butter fall. You know, the packs of Roman noodles, they have the chicken flavor in it. So I'm gonna steal from Peter. Hey Paul, y'all. So I'm going to add in a little of this chicken seasoning in here. So one of them is not gonna have one in here. That's all right. I think one pack will be enough because when you don't have, I've done this before, when you don't have chicken bouillon or chicken stock or whatever, this is a good substitute to use. I've done it before. And so we're going to add this in and then we're going to give it a taste to see how it is tasting. See if we need any more salt. I'm gonna leave that down. I'm gonna stir this in. Oh, it's looking good, y'all. It is looking good. And then we're gonna add in some more margarine. I want some more in there. And some cheese. We're gonna put our cheese in and then we're gonna add our broccoli last. Okay, so I'm going to give this a taste to see if we need any more, just a little coat spoon, see how much we need. Okay, all right, a little more pepper, got plenty of garlic, I can taste that garlic. And I think I'm gonna add in another pack of that chicken seasoning. So I'm about to grab another one, y'all. You just want to make sure your soup has plenty of flavor. Next year, I'm really going to get into more of the fresh herbs. I'm really going to start using more fresh herbs. So right now, I got the parsley and the thing, but you can use whatever you have. But it's expensive to go fresh, y'all. I ain't gonna lie, it is. It's expensive to go fresh. So use what you got until you get, you know, can be able to afford something, you know, more. And you know me, I'm just cleaning off my stove. I don't need this whisk no more, I don't think. Cleaning off my stove. I'll put it right here just in case. I need one of those things you, oh, it's getting thick. So once I get this cheese in here, it's really gonna get thick. So I don't think I need this. Well, we got to get the whisk in some more. But once I put the cheese in, it's really gonna thick up. I mean, it's really gonna thick up. Let me add this other seasoning. This other chicken stuff. Chicken seasoning that I'm gonna rob the Roman noodles. My daughter's gonna be like, what happened? So also look forward to holiday videos the next few days. Tomorrow, I believe I'm doing peanut butter fudge. This is my first time doing it. So bear with me. And Sunday, I'm going to do my strawberry daiquiri cookies. So I'm taking some in for my coworkers on Monday for Christmas. And I'm going to add in some more milk. Because I want enough liquid. I want to be able to dip my cornbread in this, y'all. Y'all probably say cornbread with broccoli soup. Yes. Okay, I'm going to add in a little more pepper because I just added some more milk. And I'm going to let that go. When I come back, I will be adding the cheese. Okay, so I'm about to add in some margarine. About the same amount I added to start my roux. So I'm going to add this into the pot. Let that melt in. And then I'm going to add my cheese. And you can use any kind of cheese you like. I have just finely shredded mild cheddar. So, you know, you could use any kind of cheese you like. You know, if you want to use whatever other kind of cheese they have, you're welcome to it. If you want to use Velveeta, hey, you're welcome to it. It's your soup. It's your dish. Make it your own. Okay, so this is really, really looking good, y'all. This is really looking good. So I'm going to start adding in my cheese a little at a time. And then I'm going to add in, once this melts in, I'm going to add in my broccoli. Sit for that, and then I'm just gonna whisk this in. Oh man, I'm sticking to the whisk, and this just gives the soup another color and flavor. You know, this is just gonna ante it up a little bit more. That's all. Oh, this looks good. This looks really good. And it's getting thick because you see it sticking to the whisk. It smells good too. And on a night like this, you know, a bowl of soup. Okay, so most of the cheese is combined in. I'm going to start adding my broccoli into the pot. Be careful, don't burn yourself. Be careful putting it in. Now broccoli, it doesn't take long to cook. It really doesn't. So you want to make sure you keep an eye on your soup. Make sure you constantly stir this because you don't want it to scorch. Scorch means you don't want it to burn. So we're just gonna keep, and I'm gonna add in, I guess you said, some more milk? Yes, because I want it to cover my broccoli. I don't want it to be like a side dish of broccoli. I want the soup to cover my broccoli. So I'm gonna add just in a little more milk here in a second, but this is looking good, y'all. Look at that. Look at that. I'm gonna be ready for this later. So we're gonna let this cook about, probably about close to 30 minutes, 25 to 30 minutes. And we're gonna turn it, I'm gonna turn it down a little bit because I don't want it to scorch, burn, and I don't want it to cook too fast. So I'm gonna add in some more milk. Clean that off. I'm going to add in some more milk. Or I can add in some more carnation. I'm gonna add in some more carnation. Then we're gonna hit it with some pepper. We're gonna give it a taste and see how the seasoning is going in it. I think it should be okay. I'm just gonna add a little more of this in because I want it to cover my broccoli. There we go. I don't want it to, there we go. I want it to cover my broccoli. So the recipe will be in the description box. Look at that. That looks good, y'all. And as you know, like I said, you can toast you some bread, make you some fresh croutons. If you don't want to do that, get you some saltine crackers. And there you have some soup, honey. Okay, I'm going to give this a taste. Let's see where we at with the salt. Salt is fine. I'm going to add some more pepper in. And a little more parsley. You talking about something good. And I'm going to cover this with a lid and let it cook for about 25, 30 minutes. And I'll be back. All right. So as you see, my soup is coming along. See my broth? I mean, it's getting thick because you can see around the edges of the pot, it's leaving a coating. So, I'm going to let my broccoli, you don't want it to like to the point where it's like falling apart. You want to still have a little, no crunch. I won't say crunch, but you want it to still be holding a little bit like that, you know. If I'm saying it correctly. And I'm just going to continue to let this cook a little bit more. And again, if you want to see more recipes like this, broccoli cheddar soup, then subscribe to my channel. I already have started on some of mine a little bit. I'm going to give it a little taste on camera so you can hear me. This is good. So, I'm going to let that continue to cook a little bit more. And again, from Joanne's Sweet and Savory Creations, bye-bye.